In this video, we will calculate the payback and discounted payback periods. We will do this for a project L and a project S. L stands for long-term cash flows, where the bigger cash flows occur later in the project's life. S stands for short-term, where the bigger project's cash flows occur early in the project's life. To calculate the payback period, you just sum these individual cash flows. So in year zero, we invest minus 1,000. Then we add 100 to it. In year one, we still owe $900. In year two, you take 900, negative 900 plus 200 for negative 700. Year three, add another 500. Year four, add 900. So negative 200 plus 900 is 700. And you can see we break even sometime between year two and year three. So the payback will be three plus something. To determine that something, we have to make an assumption. In this case, the assumption is the 900 occurs evenly throughout the year. So January has 900 divided by 12, February has 900 divided by 12, etc. If you do that, then the payback is 3 plus 2 ninths, or 3.222 years. This would not be valid, for example, in retail in the United States, where most of the cash flows would occur around Christmas season. So this would then underestimate the payback period. We can do the same thing for Project S. For Project S, again, we invest $1,000. First year, we get $500 back, so we still owe $500. Next year, we get $700 back, so we break even sometime between year one and year two. And the payback period is then 1 plus the absolute value of $500 divided by $700, are 1.714 years. One of the limitations of the payback period is it doesn't take into account time value of money or the interest you have to pay to a bank. To take that into account, we will do the discounted payback period. The difference being, we will take each cash flow, in this example, 100, and find the present value of it. So in year one, we will have 100, divided by, if the interest rate is 10%, 1.1 to the first. In year two, we will have 200 divided by 1.1 squared. In year three, 500 divided by 1.1 cubed. And in year four, 900 divided by 1.1 to the fourth. We will now sum up the discounted cash flows. Minus 1,000 plus 90 is 909.09. Plus 165 is minus 743, plus 375 is minus 368, and then plus 614, we finally go positive to 246. So again, for Project L, we break even between year 3 and year 4. To get the exact calculation, we say it's year 3, plus the absolute value of what we owe at the beginning of the year, divided by the cash flow during the year, are 3.5988 years. We can do the same thing for discounted payback. Again, we break even sometime between year one and year two, and it's going to be 1 plus 545 divided by 578 for 1.9 years. So you can see in each case, for Project S, the discounted payback is slightly longer than the payback. For Project L, the discounted payback is slightly longer than the payback to take into account time value of money. The remaining limitation of payback and discounted payback is it doesn't in any way take into account a big profit or a big loss after the payback period. To look at those sort of issues, you would have to do a calculation like NPV or IRR, which are shown in other videos. Thank you for watching this video.